Good morning, church. I hope you find some refuge in the weather with triple-digit heat index temperature that we're having. It is great to be together to worship the Lord this morning. I'm Kofi, and welcome to the fellowship of Forest Heights Baptist Church. We are glad that you have decided to log in and worship with us. I want to take a moment to extend a very warm welcome to everyone who is visiting us this morning, especially for the first time, whether you just having a look or searching out for a permanent place of worship. We are delighted to have you here to give you some idea of what that we are all about. I'll quickly scratch out some of our fundamental beliefs. We are about getting and growing people in relationship with Christ Jesus. So firstly, we are all about Jesus Christ. We believe that Jesus is who he said that he is, the Son of God who came and died for our sins. So if this is your first time in church, we hope that gets you to know him as we do, because he's truly what life is all about for us. Secondly, we are all about people. Every person who walks through our doors is important to us. I understand that you are connected online, probably from your homes, but you have walked through our doors this morning online. So if you ever feel like just another number, we are doing something wrong, and I give you permission to tell me about it. As a group of God's people, we care about you and your family. We are here not only to feed you spiritually, but also to help you in any way that we can. We love doing it, and that's why we exist. So I want to encourage you to go on our website and fill out the contact us card. We love to stay in touch with you and let you know more about ourselves. Also, if you have got a specific prayer request, please take the courage to fill out the prayer request form online anytime. We would love to pray for you, but if you don't tell us, there's nothing for us to pray for. So I encourage you to make a use of this opportunity and allow us to serve you in this way. Enjoy the rest of the worship time with us, and may the Lord bless you. We will now give the microphone to our deacon for the call to worship and prayer. Brother Deacon.
Good morning, everyone. I pray that everyone is doing well. Everyone's able to keep cool, stay out of the heat. And if you have to go out in the heat, limit the amount of time that you're out in the heat.
Yes, sir.
And for those of you who like 100 degrees,
you are muted.
Oh, I'm sorry. We are in a very trying time with the pandemic, with a number of the social strifes. And it's very easy for us to ask, does God care? Where is God in all of us and all with us in all of this? So does God care about me? Does God care about us? So I tried to look at several scriptures that confirms that yes, God does care for us. If we come to him, if we just have faith in him, he'll help us through these times. So I've selected scriptures from two books. I'm gonna go to Psalms 34, that's verses 18 to 19. And then I'd like to look at 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6 and 7. And these are just a few scriptures. There are a number of scriptures that assure us that God does care for us. So Psalms 34, verse 18, 19. Verse 18, the Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and saveth such as he I'm sorry, as such as be of a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth him out of them all. If you'll go to 1 Peter chapter 5, and that's verses 6 through 7. It says, humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Amen, and may the Lord give us understanding to this word. Let us pray. Let us pray. Father, we just come to you, Lord. We thank you, Father, first of all, for waking us up this morning, Lord, for allowing us to see another day, Father, for watching over us as we slept. And we just thank you, Father. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity, Lord, to come to you, Father, to worship you, Lord. Lord, we just pray, Father, that you give us strength. You keep us through these trying times that we're going through, Father, with the pandemic, Lord, and just with the social strifes that we're going through, Father. We know, Lord, that you care for us, Lord. We know, Father, that you will help us to make it through these times, Father. We just come to you, our faith in you, Lord. Father, we just thank you for your grace upon us. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for providing for us, Lord, when it just seems as though we were questioning. We may have a question in our minds, Lord, of how we might make it through not only the pandemic and these social strikes, but other personal issues that we may be going through, Father. We pray, Lord, for the sick, Lord. We pray for those who have been affected by the COVID virus, Lord. And we just pray, Father, that you strengthen them, that you keep them in your hands, Father. We pray for the families and the loved ones of those, Father, who have been called away from this life, Father, as a result of the virus, Lord. And we just pray, Father, that you strengthen those families, Lord, that you comfort them, Father, during their time of sorrow. Lord, we just pray, Father, again, that you give us understanding to the word that you have given and laid upon Reverend Jones's heart to deliver to us. We pray for those who are not here with us at this time, Lord, praying that you're keeping them in your hands, keeping your arms of protection around them. Lord, let our praise and worship of you, Almighty One, Father, in word and in song, be pleasing to your ear. We pray these things in the name of your Son, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Brother Deacon. Up next, we'll be singing two songs. Everyone can sing along wherever we are. We'll open up with At the Cross, performed here by Brother Joe and Brother Carlton from our church building.
Thank you.
Thank you, brothers. Up next, we will hear the second song performed here on behalf of CRC Worship. The words will be printed on the screen so we can easily follow along. Here it is, Glorify Thy Name. Thank you. Next, we will be getting an announcement from our sister Angie.
Would you like to learn to play worship piano?
Good morning. Praise the Lord. I want to welcome everybody to service today and all visitors and guests. We are glad to have you join us this Sunday and hope you'll join us again next Sunday. We have a few announcements today. Today is Communion Sunday, so I hope you have your communion ready. If not, you have time to get your resemblance of communion and be ready at the end of the service to take communion. The church council will meet tomorrow at 7 p.m., and the council members will be getting an email from me this afternoon. Please view it and review it so you'll be ready for the meeting tomorrow. Visit our website at fhbcofmd.org. If you miss a service and you want to go back and say, oh, I missed Sunday, two Sundays ago, you can always go to our website and view that that service. Deacons, you will have a meeting following the worship service today, so be prepared for your meeting. Just a personal note, maybe not personal, but pray for the family of Patrick Ellis, who passed away Thursday from the coronavirus. He's the one who Jerry contacts to put the birthdays announced on Sundays, and he passed away Thursday from the coronavirus. He's an icon in DMV. So just pray for his family. Bible study on Wednesday. Reverend Jones is ready. I think him and Deacon Little are doing something, but he said be ready for Bible study on Wednesday at 7 p.m. And when you're logging on to these Zoom meetings, make sure you pick the correct meeting that you're joining, because if you log in first and you have the wrong meeting, nobody else can get in. So make sure that you're picking the correct meeting to join in on, because it blocks the rest of us out. Let's see. I think that's all the announcements for the week. Everybody have a safe and blessed week.
Thank you, Sister Lois. Before we get to the message, we have a preacher's special from Reverend Jones. Reverend Jones?
Yes.
You are on.
Good morning. God bless you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, Forest Heights Baptist Church, friends and visitors. I take this opportunity to thank you for just being with us on the Zoom. This is the new way of us being able to touch one another. And I thank God that he's given us this opportunity to do so. The song that I'm going to render this morning, ask that you would bless me as I render this song. And if I fall short, it's all right. God will pick me up. Amen. God be praised. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, whispers of God. Born of his spirit, washed in his blood. Perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, rain from above. Echoes of mercies, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission. All is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, lost in His love. Come on. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Amen. Ah, yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much. I bless the Lord. Lord, it's in the precious name of my Lord and Savior, do I pray. Let us open in prayer. Let me open in prayer, if you would please bow your heads with me. Almighty God, I come humbly to you right now and thank you so much for this opportunity, Lord Jesus, that you allow me. I pray, Father, that you would use this vessel, O Heavenly Father, as you see fit. Place your hand upon me, O God. Touch my lips, O God. Give me the words to say, for I have none of my own. I bless you right now, O God, for all that you have done for Forest Heights Baptist Church. Bless the members and those that are visiting this day, O God, in the sound of my voice. I ask, O God, that you would bless me as I preach and teach your word as you have given it to me. For it is in the precious name of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, do I pray. Let us all say together, amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Today's message, as I have entitled, Lifted by Hope. Amen. Lifted by Hope. And the book would be John chapter 12. Verses 26 through 32. The title, Lifted by Hope, John chapter 12, verse 26 through 32. Here, before we start with the scriptures, I'd like to say a few words that Jesus was here talking to his disciples, and they were just finishing at the feast. And he was talking to his disciples and letting them know and preparing them for him to get ready to leave this world. And to get, let them know that he is the one that we ought to have our hope in, amen? And so I'm going to start with this particular verse here in chapter 26, and I'd like for you to read along with me as I read aloud, amen? If any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. Now is my soul troubled, and what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this cause came I unto this hour. Father, glorify thy name. Then came there a voice from heaven, saying, I have both glorified it and will glorify it again. The people, therefore, that stood by and heard it, said that it
that it was thunder. Others said an angel spake to him. Jesus answered and said, "This voice came not because of me, but for your sakes." Amen. Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out. If I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me. Amen. And that was John chapter 12, verses 26 through 32. And so as we go into the message this morning and realize the things that Jesus is saying to his disciples, he's speaking to those of us who love him and who follow behind him or follow in his footsteps in the righteous way for us to go. Listen to what verse 26 says again. It says, "If any man serve me, let him follow me, and where I am, there shall also my servant be." Thank you, Lord. "If any man serve me, him will my Father honor." Death will come to Jesus. And if we are his servants, we may have to lose our life and service and witness for him. Now some may take that kind of harsh, and it seems like it may be kind of harsh because we may have to give our life for Jesus. Do you find that to be a problem? Do you find that to be an issue in your own life, whether or not you would consider to give your life for Jesus if it came to that? It's a challenge in which we have to accept as believers in Christ, that others may not believe what we say. Others may be infuriated because we say that we love the Lord. They may be damaged in their own lives because of their relationship that they do not have with him. But Jesus says in his words that where he goes, we will be. He's going to always be with us. And then he also says to us that his Father will honor us as well. Amen. That's a blessing within itself, knowing that because we follow our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the hope that we have in him because of his death, that the Father will also honor each of us. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. In verse 27, it says this. It says, "Now is my soul troubled." Listen to him. "And what shall I say? Father, save me from this hour. But for this cause came I unto this hour." Jesus is talking to his disciples. He's talking to those of us who follow him and helping us to understand that this hour that he has to serve, he knows that that hour is to come. But if you listen to that first portion of that scripture there, you can hear right there that Jesus was indeed a full man on this earth, because he's asking Father to save him. Listen to it. It says, "Now is my soul troubled," he says. That's on man's side. He's troubled. And then it goes on and he says, "And what shall I say?" What shall I say? What words do I have of my own that I should say because I'm troubled? Well, what he said is, "Father," he called upon his Father is what he did, because he knows that the trouble that he has to deal with, he's dependent on his Father. So he calls out his name, "Father, save me from this hour." See, he called on his Father. He's recognizing the fact that that's who he is and that's who he needs to call on. We need to be able to do the same thing, brothers and sisters. None of us are above that. None of us can handle these situations by ourselves. Believe what I'm saying. This is God's word, not mine. The words that I'm telling you right now are right out of the scriptures. And it says here, he called upon his Father, "Save me from this hour." But he says, for this cause came I unto this hour. For what cause? Because he loves each of us. Because he loves you so much that he comes to this hour. He knows what he has to go through. And in this troubled time on the man's side of Jesus Christ, him being on earth, on the man's side, he calls upon his Father. No different than what you and I are supposed to do. Any troubles that we have, any problems that we have, we must call upon the Father. Yes. And ask him to come forth. And he says that he recognized the reason of why he's there. He knows why he's there. He's there for the cause that his father had given him, the reasons for being there for us. He is sacrificing himself for our sins. Bless you, Lord. Verse 28 says this. It says, Father, glorify thy name. Then came there a voice from heaven saying, I have both glorified it and will glorify it again. Amen. Yes, sir. He's already glorified it. And he said he's going to glorify it again. This is the principle Jesus lived by, to glorify his Father. I would like to think that I glorify God in the things that I do. To help me do that is to understand his word. To help me do that is when we as a church come together and have Bible study like you did this morning and listen to one another, share the word of God, glorify his name and lift his name high with song and praise. Just like you did this morning. God be praised. The word of God is truthful in what it says to us. Listen to this. There's two places that God has come and raised his voice, or people could hear his voice as he spoke to his son. I want you to write these scriptures down, and you can go to them later on. One is in Matthew chapter 3, verse 17. Matthew chapter 3, verse 17. And then also in Matthew 17, 5 and 13, and in Matthew 3:17, it talks about his baptism, and Matthew 17:5, his transfiguration. Amen. So he called upon his name. His father spoke, and they heard his voice. Listen to what it says in verse 29. It says, the people therefore that stood by and heard it said that it thundered. Others said, an angel spake to him. And so those that were around there, around Jesus at the time, they could actually hear the voice. They heard the voice, but they had no idea who it was. It didn't faze them who it was, knowing that he had already called upon his father. When he said, Father, his father heard him, and his father responded. That's what God does for us. When we pray and talk to his son and ask his son to help us to get through whatever we need to go through, he calls upon his father and his father responds. You hear his voice, you hear him speak to you, you know that it's him. You know that it's him because the relationship that you have with him, you know who God is. I can't tell you whether or not you love the Lord or not. You must say that out of your own mouth, amen? And not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And we ought to be able to say that out of our own mouths. And the people that were standing by there, they heard the voice, but they couldn't make it out. They wasn't sure. I wonder if that happened to us today, would we recognize his voice? You know, the Father knows us, about each of us. Yeah. The shepherd knows his sheep. Do we know the shepherd is the question. If he spoke to you today, would you be able to say, that's my God that's speaking to me? I ought not to do that particular thing. The challenge that he gives us in knowing that we have a relationship with him is most important, and that when we hear his name, that we respond to what he says. Those who were there to witness this hope we as believers in Christ Jesus have today did not understand what happened. They had hope. We got hope now. They didn't know what happened, but we have hope in Jesus Christ. Once he responded, his father responded to him and told him, I glorify you, my friend, twice now. And so it is indeed something that we need to be proud of in our relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Listen to what verse 30 says. It says, Jesus answered and said, this voice came not because of me, but for your sakes. That's why it came. This voice you heard was not because of me, was for you, is who it is for. And so it was a confirmation, if you will, that when Jesus called upon his Father the same way that we do, that he will respond. And he did respond to his son. He let him know that he was dead, and he answered him. And that same way, we must be able to have that same hope in the sense of our relationship with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. There is no other way for us to be able to make it and have hope unless we have the hope in what Jesus Christ has done for us. He recognized his cause. He said it in the verse behind this. He said he came here and he knows what his cause is all about. He knows why he's there. But again, he called upon his Father for our sake. Amen. He called because of our sake. That's the issue. Mm-hmm. And so I want to thank God for him looking out for each of us as we listen to his word. Amen. This day. Verse 28, he spoke to his Father. Yeah. We need to be able to speak to the Father the same way. Don't be afraid to talk to Jesus to get to the Father. That's the only way that we can do it. He will speak on our behalf. Even if you don't have the right words to say, or you feel that you don't have the right words to say, it's all right. Tell him what's on your heart. He'll hear your word, and he will respond the same way that he did to his son when he called upon his name. Yes. He's going to give you an answer. It may not be the answer that you're looking for, amen? So be prepared for what he tells you is what you ought to do. It's what you deserve, understood? And so the issue is that when we call on him, we might not get the answer that we want, but he's going to give us what we need. That's what his Father does. He provides for each of us, amen? Thank you, Lord. And listen to verse 31. It says, now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out. He's letting us know that because he's gonna be on that cross, this is the time. It's coming right now. The prince of this world. You know what you're talking about. Yeah, he's talking about Satan, you know, and he's going to be cast out is what he's going to be. Jesus says the judgment of this world takes place today. And Satan is cast out, period. Amen. He's gone. We don't even have to worry about that rascal anymore when that time comes, providing we have a relationship with him. We have to accept Christ as our personal Lord and Savior. That's important. Otherwise, we won't understand when he says that he's cast out. How do you get cast out? What do you mean? Well, you find out when the word of God comes to you and he makes it plain to you that because of my son, you live. You will have life everlasting. Amen? You accept Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. That's the hope that we have. But the last sentence here, the last scripture here helps us to understand what Jesus is saying to those that he's speaking to at that day. He's still speaking to us this day. Listen to what this last sentence says, his last paragraph here. It says this. It says, and I, if I be lifted up from the earth, amen, will draw all men unto me. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, he's talking about when he is going to be on that cross, and he's going to talk about the time frame that they nail him to that cross, and yes, then they lift that cross up. He said, if I be, yes, lifted up, he's going to draw all men unto him. That means that we have a Savior. That's what gives us the hope that we have every day, because he was lifted up. And even though he was lifted up for that day, he knew why he was there. He explained to us. He helped us to understand why he was there. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for giving your life for each of us, even for me.
Amen.
He called upon his Father, and his Father answered, and he recognized the reason why he's there. He says to all of them that's standing there that hears his voice, he said, if I be lifted up, and when they lifted that cross up, then and only then did they realize that this was the Son of God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, giving us the hope because you were lifted up. And so the title of this message this morning, Lift Up. The word of God.
Amen.
Do not stop believing in the word of God. If I be lifted up, he says, I'll draw all men unto me. That is inclusive. That means men and women, every one of us. If you believe in him, if he's lifted up and you follow behind him as his disciples are, and we be obedient to his word, then we will be lifted up and understand that we have the hope that we have. Amen. My brothers and my sisters, my prayer is this, that you have been lifted by hope. Amen.
Amen.
God be praised. Amen. Thank you so much. Let you, if you would please bow your head with me as I close out with a prayer and thank God for this opportunity. Won't you bow your heads? Almighty God, I come humbly to you again this day, and I just want to thank you again for the opportunity that you've allowed me to speak your word, oh God, to speak the truth that you have given us, making it plain, oh Heavenly Father, that each of us may understand your word. I pray, Father, wherever I have stumbled, that you have cleared it in their hearts, oh Heavenly Father, they understood what you want them to understand. Thank you for your son, Jesus, who died for us, oh Heavenly Father, who was lifted up. In his own words, he says, if he be lifted up, that he would draw all men unto him. This is my prayer today, oh God, that those that have not accepted your son, Jesus, as their personal Lord and Savior, that they would do that this day. Amen. Thank you, Father, for this is my prayer in the precious name of your son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, do I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Today is third Sunday. It's the time in which we have communion and we do be obedient to God's word. And remembrance of him is what he asked us to do. And that's for our communion. And so as we begin, let me say a prayer and bless the table. Let us bow our heads. Almighty God, humbly do we as your people come before you this day in obedience to your word, that we would commune with you in the sense of us remembering your son, Jesus, as he has asked us to. And so, Father, I ask that you will bless this bread that is the representative of your body and bless the wine that is your blood. These are the things that you have shared for us and for our sins. And so, Father, we ask that you would bless them as we commune together this day. Amen. If you would, please, I would ask that you would get your bread. When Jesus was betrayed, he took the bread and he blessed it. And as he blessed the bread, he did likewise with the wine. And he said, this is my body that I give for you. I ask that you would take your bread and eat it in representation of the body of Christ. Let us commune together. He then took the cup and he blessed it. And he said, this is my blood given for many for the remission of sin. Let us commune together. After they had supped, they had sang a song and they departed. But before we depart, let me close with a word or two to those who are here today who have not accepted Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. I would ask if you have not accepted Christ as your personal Lord and Savior that you would bow your head with me and repeat after me. Almighty God, I come to you this day as a sinner, recognizing that I am a sinner. I ask, oh God, that your son Jesus would accept me as I am and save my soul. Father, I believe that your son, Jesus, died for me. He was buried, and on the third day, he was raised. That I do believe. And so I ask again, Father, that you, son, Jesus, would accept me as I am and save my soul. Amen. If you prayed that prayer this morning with me and you have not accepted Christ and you decide to do so today, then there's two things I'd like for you to consider to do. One, I'm going to give you the telephone number to our church. And if you want to join with us at Forest Heights Baptist Church, we would love to have you. I would like for you to call this number. It's area code 301-839-1166. 301-839-1166. 66. And if you don't want to join with us at Forest Heights Baptist Church, that's all right. What I want you to do is talk to one of your members at your church or your family members and ask them, that tell them that you have accepted Christ and you would like to join a particular church. Amen? God be praised.
Amen.
So after they had taken the bread and the wine and they had supped, the word says that they had sung a song and then they departed. So let's sing a song together, or at least one word or one sentence of the song together, if you will, and then we will depart. Amen? Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, birth from above, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. Amen. I say to you all, God bless you and go in peace. God bless you.